Jesus takes these three disciples to a high mountain. But it is Luke who tells us the reason why they went to that high mountain, to pray. And as they were praying, his garments, his appearance, became white as light, and intensely white, dazzling white. There appeared the two men that we heard about, Moses and Elijah, representing the law and the prophets. Again, it is Luke who fills us in on the conversation. He spoke of his departure, which he was to accomplish at Jerusalem. During this encounter, Peter was overcome with emotion, and as we heard, wanted to institutionalize the event by building a shrine, wanting to make a heavenly moment, something like a monument, something permanent, something concrete. And he wanted to remain there in this glorious moment, I believe. As Peter said this, a cloud came over and overshadowed them, and a voice came from the cloud. "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." After hearing what the Synoptic Gospels tell us in Matthew and Mark and Luke, we ask, could this unusual, strange story have any meaning for me or for you? Any relationship to my life as a Christian today? As strange as it may sound to you and to me, God comes and meets us where we are. Here's the invitation. A moment of worship, wine on the lips, bread in the hand, and Jesus comes. Many of you may have experienced this in your life for a moment like Peter and James and John. God's glory was revealed. Each one of us, maybe in our own way, can remember a moment or several where we experienced personally, deeply, God's presence. Well, a second observation for me about this story is simply what the disciples experienced, what they physically did. They came off the mountain back to the valley, as Jesus did. As soon as Jesus comes down off the mountain, all of a sudden, life gets back to normal. There seems to be just enough mountaintop experiences and mountaintop peaks to get us through the lonesome valleys. Reality still intrudes, and life is sometimes tough and crowded and difficult and cruel and mean and unfair. But, my friends in Christ, the test of any vision is what we do when we get back down to the bottom of the mountain. Each one of us in our baptism and our confirmation has been called, has been empowered to be Christ's light, Christ himself to those around us. And collectively, we as a church can and must do so much as Christ's hands and his arms and his feet, and his eyes. The promise of God is that the transfiguration happens. The mountaintop experience happens for us. They happen so that we can be empowered and our faith be fed. Amen.